we're both going to be very into sanctuary, so it's like there.
Thank you. All rise. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Please be seated. We are blessed, as always, to be able to gather together in God's house as brothers and sisters in Christ. And today we celebrate the life and the blessings that God gave to Rena and how He made her a blessing to all of us. A Christian funeral is different than the world grieves because we grieve with hope. And that's kind of an oxymoron phrase. We grieve with hope, as St. Paul says. We do still grieve. There is still sorrow there. But there's also the joy of knowing that we will see Rena once again and be reunited in heaven when Christ comes to wake us all from the dead. And so that's the hope and the certainty that we have. And we celebrate that today as well. So it's okay to shed a tear or two. Don't let anybody tell you that it's wrong or that if your faith was strong enough, you wouldn't cry. Even Jesus cried at the grave of his dear friend Lazarus because death is a terrible, ugly thing. But The good news is Jesus has destroyed the power of death, and that's what we celebrate today as well. So there's joy even through the grieving and the suffering. A few notes about the service today. During our opening hymn, you'll see that five stanzas are listed there, but all eight are printed. My mistake, sorry about that. What we'll do is we will sing just the stanzas listed. So you sing two stanzas, you skip two, then sing one and skip one, and then sing the rest. So sorry about any confusion there. And then also a couple of things after, on the second to last page of the service part, you'll see the collect listed there, and then there are two prayers after. Just a note that those are prayers for the committal service at the cemetery after the service, and so I will not be having those as part of this service. And then also after the closing hymn, these are instructions for all of us. First of all, we'll have a time for sharing. A couple of family members would like to share some memories and thanksgivings about Rena and lessons that they learned from her life. But so we'll have that time for sharing first. Then Wayne has requested special music, and that is the Hallelujah Chorus from Handel's Messiah. So that was very special to Rena. And so we're all going to remain seated and listen to the Hallelujah Chorus, which is really the celebration that we all will take part of in heaven when we are there celebrating Christ's victory over death and our reunion in heaven.
That's what Rena's request. My last promise to her.
And so, yeah, Wayne just said that was Rena's last request and Wayne's sincere promise to her that we would play and listen to the Hallelujah Chorus. And so, very special to Rena and very special to all of us as well. And then we will have a recessional, as we would traditionally do for a funeral. But the family wants everybody to be aware, because of time constraints at the cemetery, they're hoping to get over to the cemetery and have just a private, just with the family and Pastor Pett leading the committal service right after the service here. And everyone else is welcome to come to the fellowship hall for the luncheon. And we will, I will lead in a prayer, and we will begin to start serving right away then, and the family will come after the committal service there. So just so everybody is aware of that, that's how that will work. Okay, did I cover everything I need to? I think so. So with that, we now give thanks to God for the life and blessings to Rena, and as she has been a blessing to all of us. And we begin with our opening hymn, I Know That My Redeemer Lives, remembering we're going to only sing these selected stanzas.
Thank you.
and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
He will cover you with his pinions, and under his wings you will find refuge.
His faithfulness is a shield and a harbor.
You will not fear the terror of the night,
nor the arrow that flies by day,
nor the pestilence that stalks in darkness,
nor the destruction that wastes at noonday.
1,000 may fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand,
but it will not come near you.
You will only look with your eyes
and see the attack of the wicked.
Because you have made the Lord your dwelling place,
the Most High, who is my refuge,
no evil shall be allowed to befall you,
no plague come near your tent.
For he will command his angels concerning you
to guard you in all your ways.
On their hands they will bear you up,
lest you strike your foot against the stone.
You will tread on the lion and the adder,
and on the lion and the serpent will trample underfoot.
Because he holds fast the knee in love, I will deliver him.
I will protect him because he knows my name.
When he calls to me, I will answer him.
I will be with him in trouble.
I will rescue him and honor him.
With all might I will satisfy him and show him my salvation.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us. Lord, have mercy upon us.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and mercy, we give thanks for your loving kindness shown to Rena and to all your servants, who having finished their course in faith, now rest from their labors. Grant that we also may be faithful unto death and receive the crown of eternal life through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
We sing the first three stanzas of For All the Saints. You may be seated.
Amen.
Today's first reading comes from Job 19, verses 23 through 27. Job said, "Oh, that my words were written, oh, that they were inscribed in the book, oh, that with an iron pen and lead they were engraved in the rock forever. For I know that my Redeemer lives, and at the last he will stand upon the earth. After my skin has thus been destroyed, yet in my flesh I shall see God. Whom shall I see for myself? And my eyes shall behold and not another. My heart faints within me. This is the word of the Lord."
Thanks be to God.
Ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I have been fully known. So now, faith, hope, and love abide, these three, but the greatest of these is love. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Myself, that where I am, you may be also. And you know the way to where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way, and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you had known me, you would have known my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
We sing our next hymn, Lord, Take My Hand and Lead Me. Please be seated.
Thank you.
God has made us his people through our baptism into Christ. Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
We sing to God be the glory. Please be seated.
Verses 1 through 13, and this was the same text that was preached
I'm Rena with Wings Red. For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to pluck up what is planted. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to break down, and a time to build up. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones, and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to see, and a time to lose. A time to keep, and a time to cast away. A time to tear, and a time to sow. A time to keep silence, and a time to speak. A time to love, and a time to hate. A time for war, and a time for peace. What gain has the worker from his toil? I have seen the business that God has given to the children of man to be busy with. He has made everything beautiful in its time. Also, he has put eternity in a man's heart, yet so that he cannot find out what God has done from beginning to the end. I perceive that there is nothing better for them than to be joyful and to do good as long as they live. Also that everyone should eat and drink and take pleasure in all his toil. This is God's gift to man. This is our text. Please pray. Dear Lord Jesus, we pray, fill us with your Holy Spirit, the Comforter. Bring us the comfort that we need in this hour and in the days ahead. Remind us that you indeed have made everything beautiful in its time. There is indeed a time to be born and a time to die. A time to laugh and a time to weep and a time to mourn. Give us this time, but also fill us with hope in the midst of it. Hope of your times. Hope of what you have prepared. Hope in life that you have given. Hope in a life that we share by faith is a gift from you. In your name, amen.
Time. Time is everything. You know, we think about all the things that were so important to Rena that required timing. Music. If you're going to play music right, if you're going to play music well, you need good timing. Because otherwise it's just notes and it sounds horrible. But played to the correct timing, it's beautiful and a joy to hear. Timing. Think of all the services, for those who have ever been in a service that Rena played here in this sanctuary, timing. Her portion of liturgy, pastor speaking his portion, her portion of liturgy, pastor speaking his portion, timing. She plays over him. Well. But timing, so important. Timing. Time to live. Time to die. You know, it didn't surprise me too much that Wayne, being a kid that grew up in the 60s, would want this passage. Not only because it was used in his wedding, maybe because he listened to it, you know, played by the birds for those so many years, but I want you to think what God is saying about this. Timing. It was God's timing that brought Rena here to Good Shepherd. It was God's timing that things took place as they did. It was God's timing that brought Rena and Wayne together. God's timing met needs that each of them had. Rena needed, Wayne needed, her children needed, his children needed, families needed, and the timing that God brought together. And it didn't mean that everything was going to be perfect. And it didn't mean that everything was going to be exactly right away. And it didn't mean that everything was going to be, the Partridge Family and the Brady Bunch and everything all rolled into one. The timing. And if you look at the passage and you look at that last section, right, I really hope that you put that in front of you. Look at Ecclesiastes 3. In that last paragraph, look at verse 11 again. Please take it out and put it in front of you. He has made, read with me. He has made everything beautiful in its time. You think this family, this quote unquote makeshift Brady Bunch, came together and was perfect from the get-go? I know for a fact it wasn't. But did it become beautiful? Absolutely. It became beautiful as Rena recognized there was a time to love. Time to love as best she could in comparison to the love of Christ. Because in the epistle reading that she chose, love is patient, love is kind, love does not envy your goals. No human is capable of this kind of love. Not one of us. But that's the perfect love of Christ. The perfect love of Christ that not only does he set up an example, but the perfect love of Christ that he fulfilled by coming into this world and out of perfect love went to death on a cross. And out of perfect love gave his life for each and every one of us. And out of perfect love he made the ultimate sacrifice. And out of perfect love he rose from that grave. And just as the scriptures said that, and after 3 days' time, he rose. And that was the perfect time for each and every one of us. So we're going to ask ourselves, was it the perfect time that God called Rena to himself? No. I think Wayne would say no. I think Mitzi, Tim, Tom, Jenny, Ben, and Tim would all say no. All the family would say no. But whose time was it? God's time. And when you look at that last paragraph and do it again, listen to that next one. That same verse 11. He has also put eternity in a man's heart, yet so that he cannot find out what God has done from the beginning to the end. You see, as he places eternity into our hearts, there are people who recognize it and embrace it. Every believer in Jesus Christ recognizes that and embraces it. Embraces the concept of eternity. Embraces the concept that Jesus has gone to prepare a place for us. Embraces the concept that we have an eternal home with him because of his resurrection. We embrace the concept of eternity. But as many of us that believe, there are as many of those who reject this concept of eternity. Death is an end. That's it. You're worm food. But for us who believe, we hold tightly to that hope. We hold tightly to that comfort, even though we don't always understand what God's doing, why he's doing it, why is his timing as such, why is it this way now, why did this happen to happen now? Why?
But Job questioned it. Job questioned it over and over again when you read the book of Job. And finally, Job comes to what we hear in our Old Testament reading and says, what? I know that my Redeemer lives, and in the end he will stand upon the earth, and even as my skin is destroyed, yet in my flesh I will see God. See God. I can see you face to face. So again, see God. And so many others who have gone before us in faith.
Thank you.
Your Honor is prepared. Let us pray to the Lord, our God and Father, who raised Jesus from the dead. Almighty God, you have knit your chosen people together into one communion in the mystical body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to newness of life, and so pass with him through the gate of death and the grave to our joyful resurrection. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Grant that all who have been nourished by the body and blood of your Son may be raised immortality and incorruption to be seated with him at your heavenly banquet. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give to the Pett family and to all who mourn comfort in their grief and a confidence in your loving care, that casting all their sorrow on you, that they may know the consolation of your love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Give courage and faith to the bereaved, that within the communion of your church they may have strength to meet the days ahead in the assurance of a holy and certain hope, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love who have departed in the faith. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Help us, we pray, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and find comfort in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Receive our thanks for Rena and for all the blessings you bestowed on her in this earthly life. Bring us at last to our heavenly home, that with Rena we may see you face to face in the joys of paradise. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
O God of all grace, you sent your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, to bring life and immortality to life. We give you thanks that by his death he has destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Strengthen us in the confidence that because he lives, we shall live also, and that neither death nor life nor things present nor things to come will be able to separate us from your love, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Our nation may be seated as we sing in the 763.
taught by our Lord and trusting his promises, we are bold to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Lord,
now in this your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people. A light to reveal you to the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, it is now, and it will be forever. Amen.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. We sing the next hymn. I wanted to introduce this a little bit. This was very special to Rena and to the family because her grandfather wrote this hymn. Help me get this right, the way her grandfather wrote the words and the music, right? Is that?
Just
the music. Okay.
Right,
yes. All right, so the family is going to sing the first stanza and lead us all, and then listen to them also sing the refrain, and then we'll join in for the second stanza and following after we hear kind of how it goes. So please be seated.
Thank you.
be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Lord God, our shepherd, you gather the lambs of your flock into the arms of mercy and bring them home. Comfort us with the certain hope of the resurrection to everlasting life and a joyful reunion with those we love who have died in the faith. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace.
In the name of the Lord. Amen.
And we sing, Great is thy faithfulness. Please be seated.
Thank you. I'm going to open with. She wanted me to read a poem that my grandmother wrote in 1933 before she was a Temple Road runner. She was Temple Sandy at Teachers College, where my mother later had my mother really obviously admired her mother. So she obviously taught me how to be a daughter, too. It's entitled Time. She spent away a month today. And though 'tis said that time will find the cure for aches when parting breaks the hearts of those who are left behind. She's been away a month today. I miss her more and bitterly. Ah, to endure till time can cure this deepening wound along with me. The other treasure I found in her little nest that I think she repeatedly read daily at the end to remind herself of who she was something that my grandmother wrote to her in college during a difficult time. Claudette, we were off a year. She actually graduated in 1966, not 1965, so she's been a little longer. That's okay. Still taking me forever. Rena Lou, you'll be a really fine jewel someday, yes? You're very precious to us anyway. But if you can accept all the bumps you've had and remember the message that is enclosed, tell me, you'll come out on top, I'm sure. It is a devotional from Friday, January 21st, 1960-something, and it's based off of Malachi chapter 3. And it's titled Precious Jewels. I, the Lord, make up my jewels. Someday the Lord will return from heaven to joyously collect his jewels, that they may shine eternally with undimmed luster in the kingdom of his Father. In this life, therefore, God often puts us upon the grinding wheel of trial, that he may begin the necessary shining up process that his rough gems require. If you will just remember that this often unpleasant grasping is adding to our preciousness, we will take the buffing of adversity with holy joy and unwavering faithfulness. When in Amsterdam, Holland last summer, said a traveler, I was much interested in a visit we made to a place that was famous for polishing diamonds. We saw many men engaged in the work. In bold, the streets. When a diamond is found, it is rough and dark like a common pebble. It takes many long hours to polish it, and it is very hard work. It is held close to the surface of a large revolving wheel. Fine diamond dust is used as a grinding powder, for nothing else is hard enough to polish the stone. Sometimes, the buffing must be continued for many months. If the diamond is intended for a king or even some dignitary, then even more time or trouble must be spent upon it. Is it any wonder, then, that our Lord calls his own beloved ones his jewels? To fit them for beautifying his crown, they too must be polished like diamonds, and so he allows trouble to buffet us, that we may lose our innate darkness and better reflect the light of his glory. Thus we come to find the true and many-sided bevel of holiness, as sin and evil habits are ground off by the sanctified wheel of time. Nana, circle this and underline it. Are you one of his precious jewels? Then do not be surprised if in life you get a good polishing. Like the stars in the morning, his bright crown adorning, they shall shine in their beauty, bright gems for his crown. God of the day, God's jewels are gathered in grace, bought with blood, polished by pain, and destined for his diadem. And my Nana was infamous for leaving little notes. It says, be fair, be merciful, forgiving, be humble, love everything, do not criticize, share, teach Christ, love man, and recognize human dignity. In closing, this is something that I know she read to me on occasion when she lost a dear friend to her. And so I feel it is only fitting that we read it for her. God saw that she was getting tired and a cure was not to be. So he put his arms around her and whispered, "Come with me." With tearful eyes, you watched her suffer and saw her slowly fade away. Although you loved her dearly, you could not make her stay. A golden heart stopped beating, hardworking hands put to rest. God broke your hearts to prove to you he only takes the best. Thank you. I'll hold you up. Oh, you guys have
it. Okay. So, contrary to Pett tradition, I shall be brief. 28 years ago, tomorrow, we all gathered here together, yep. And we stood side by side. And I would say a good 2/3 of us were not on board, but our parents, in their wisdom, did it anyway. And here we are together now. And we love each other, and we are a family. And one of the things that I would say, one of the biggest things that Rena taught me, she was one of the best examples of loving like Jesus that I've ever seen. She was patient, and she was kind, and she had occasional righteous anger.
Righteous
anger. But above all, she was forgiving. And it didn't matter how many times we did it for her. She came back with loving arms, and she was the step mom, the grace mom we all needed. And I will never, I will never be able to pay that back. No worries.
Their family didn't sing it different. the fault of my cousin Paul, you know, the evil of the red man, the evil of the red man.
At this time, we will listen to the Hallelujah Chorus by George Friedrich Handel, played for us a recording, of course, from the London Philharmonic Orchestra. Now, when Handel debuted this Messiah in London, King George II was so moved that he, when they got to the Hallelujah Chorus part, that he rose and everybody rose with him. And it's been a tradition ever since King George stood for that, that everyone stands for the Hallelujah Chorus. And then after the Hallelujah Chorus is finished, then the pastors will leave the casket out and the family, and will remain standing to honor the family. And at that point, then the congregation can kind of filter out behind as well. So we rise to hear the Hallelujah Chorus. If you want to sing a little bit, that's okay too.